A.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. Trade what you see with Larry Pesavento. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648 or internationally at 727-873-7618. Now, Larry Pesavento.
Okay, looking good, Billy Ray, feeling good, Lewis. We've got a caller this morning that we are certainly going to want to hear from, and that's Shane Smolian, the Wolf Trader. How are you doing, my friend?
Good morning, Larry. Can you hear me?
I hear you perfectly. Is the volatility enough for you today?
Oh, my goodness. Did you see that jobs number out there?
Yes, sir. Things are okay in River City. We're back to normal. Everything's going to be great. Christmas is going to come on July 4th this year, so make sure you get your shopping done, my friend. Yeah. What do you got for us today, buddy?
Well, can you see the slide there I got there?
Yes, we've got it up.
Okay, so I started out just by showing the unemployment number. It's up 2.5 million non-farm payrolls, and the unemployment's at 13.3. That's a big increase. And so bigger than I expected, but I did expect a recovery, and this is a good sign. I'm really happy to see this. I'm happy for everybody. That's good. This is good news for everybody. This is really good stuff. So I just wanted to put that out there because that's breaking news. But I'm going to talk a little bit about this eclipse that's going on in the sky right now. So this is interesting. This is a lunar eclipse, and I talk about this in the newsletter for the subscribers. I actually put a graph of it to show how the market behaves around the lunar eclipse. And then, of course, later in the month, we have the solar eclipse. But this is the actual pattern of the lunar eclipse. So when we have a lunar eclipse, we have a direct alignment with the sun and the moon. It's a full moon, and then the Earth is creating this shadow. And what we like to look at is the aspects that it makes with the other planets. And right now, this is making a T-square with Mars, and that's a signature of war. And so this goes very well with the riots and the protests that have been going on in the country. Saturn's also in the picture if we look at a 135-degree angle from the fourth harmonic. But this is a very difficult planetary picture. So, you know, when you get these eclipses, we got to look at the whole thing. And Mars is also with Neptune there. So that is, you know, Mars and Neptune is hidden motives or hidden deception. And so a lot of times, you know, when you see this type of action, it's like a passive aggressive type of an action. Or, you know, a lot of times these protesters are shipped in from other cities and agitators come in. And that's a typical Mars Neptune signature. So when we see that, you know, you tend to see. And you know, this can also be the spread of disease too. But Mars Neptune, when it's in this kind of a picture, it's kind of a deceptive energy that goes along with that Mars. So this is a challenging aspect for sure. This is a pattern of who's going to see this eclipse night. It's mainly over Africa, Europe, and in Asia and Australia. So this makes a much larger shadow than the solar eclipse, because the solar eclipse, you know, it's a much smaller path that it travels through. So, more, you know, if you're in this part of the world tonight, you'll be able to see it as it passes over and it makes that shadow on the moon. Now, this is a scenario that I did talk about in right around June 1st, the melt-up scenario.
Sure did. You said it three or four times, and I raised my hand, and I said, I'm a believer, so go ahead, my friend.
Sure, and again, this is just a scenario, but I think, and when I saw this happening, the Astro had made a sell, and we went flat on the S&P. We caught the rally, from a good part of this rally, up to about last Friday, and then I went flat, and when the market tends to rally into a falling Astro, that creates what Elliott Wave calls a running correction. In other words, the cycle is down, but the market is still going up. And so when that happens, the market can tend to drift higher. And when it hits that cycle low, which we're going to see on June the 12th, it can tend to have an even stronger parabolic rise up. Now, it's not guaranteed that this will happen, but when I saw that start to occur a few days ago, it was like 4 days ago, I said, well, this is probably a melt-up scenario. It's very rare that this happens, but it can rally into falling astros. So I think this is what's unfolding right now. But the when you have a lunar eclipse, the market tends to rally up to the day of the eclipse, and then it falls for about 5 days. And I have a graph of this for subscribers. So if you sign up for the newsletter, you can see it on the website at wolftraderfutures.com. And so there's a trial. You can go there. But I'm starting to put the interim updates also on the website, so you get the newsletter and then all of the updates that I send, because there's so much happening. Like, this is unfolding at such a rapid rate. But this is great news. I mean, this is great for the economy. This is great for everybody. We all need to get the economy going again. And I think this is really going to go a long way to helping out if this market can start to see new highs here. So I really think this is what's happening, but we have to wait and see, because the eclipse, like I said, the next 5 days could be a pullback or some type of a lateral movement. But when you got a rise that's this strong, when you have a pullback, even like with an eclipse, it could just be like a sideways pattern, and then it hits up on the 12th. So, I also look at the RSI. So, for example, when you're in a big rally, like a lot of like this is the S&P here. This is the RSI. So right now we're at 86. The S&P doesn't like to see values above 93. And when you're in a rally, a pullback can be somewhere between 50 to 65% when you're in a melt up scenario. So if this thing can pull back to an RSI of about 65% on the 12th, I would feel pretty good about our chances of really stair stepping back up higher after that point. And so I think you had on, who was it? Hema, the woman you had on was talking about.
Hema Reddy, yes.
Uh-huh. Yeah, she talks about this too, that the RSI characteristics change according to what's happening. So when you're in a rally, the pullback is much, the base is like higher. So between, like, I think 65% would be a really good base if this can pull back. But clearly we're in a good state of mind here, and I really hope that this can continue for the country, because we really need it. I mean, we're having some really rough times right now, with everything that's going on between coronavirus and the George Floyd situation, and it's a tough time. So, this could be really good for the country. Now, this is a graph of the weekly Fed juice. So, I talk about this in the newsletter and the gold service, but we've really never seen it has just continued higher. So on the weekly time frame, I've always been bullish, and I've never changed the stance here. I mean, I really believe this. I've said this from the beginning, that we're still in a bull market. And even when it was pressing down to these lows on the 20th, on March the 20th, I put out a tweet on the Twitter. It's Wolf Trader FUTU1, Wolf Trader FUTU1, and I pinned it to the top, and I said, I think we're going to have a full recovery, and I think we're going to figure this out. And so ever since then, it's been going up. And the reason that I said that was, I'm not just being rah-rah optimistic. I mean, I do believe in the country. I think this is the greatest country on earth, and we have the best minds on this. The best men and women are working on these solutions. But I also look at what the Fed is doing, and the Fed has been spectacular. I know people have mixed feelings about the Fed, but in situations like this, Jerome Powell has done an outstanding job with continuing. He started the QE, he started the new corporate credit facilities, and that really helps too, because that helped the credit bond markets.
Hey, Shane, thanks for joining us today. I know you've got to run to do some work with Vanessa, so we'll have you on next week, maybe, and may God bless. Be safe.
Thanks, Larry. You too. Take care.
You bet. 877-927-6648.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Okay, folks, thanks, Shane, for being on this morning and giving us all that data. The one thing I've learned in all these years of trading, boy, you've got to believe these numbers that the government gives us because they're never wrong. I can remember one, well, there's been more than one, maybe two, that were wrong in the 60 years I've been doing this. But no matter what it is, it's very positive, and the country is really starting to get back to work. There's no more SARS virus, so we'll be at full employment by July 4th. So looking good, Billy Ray, feeling good, Lewis. But there's one market that's in big trouble that we've been talking about for quite some time, also bringing us good news. And that, of course, is the old Treasury bond market. We are looking at higher interest rates and not lower interest rates. As you can see here, we went shattering through the 382 level at 176. We said that was very bearish. If we went below 176, we went down below the 61% retracement today at 173. We're currently trading at 171.26. So at least we're going to have high, you know, interest rates are going to be higher. So if you're going to do your house, if you have a house, hasn't been burned down, we'll see what's going to be looking on. David is telling us that the record short sales of all time yesterday. I really don't. Yes, I sold my life jacket. Actually, I bought a bulletproof vest, Peter, because now they're going to defund the police departments. Now, this is really, really smart. You got to love politicians, especially Eric Garcetti, who's the son of Gil Garcetti, who was the guy that got O.J. off the hook because he was the attorney general back in those days of L.A. But the main thing is, I've heard of some really silly things. Stop it. Let's get off the soapbox. Larry, yes, yo, baby. Judge is ruling. Okay, now we just made a big ABCD correction up there at that oil at 39.60. The number was 39.50. So whether that works, if you did that, make sure that you put your stop at break even. Let's take a look at a couple of these things that we've been watching along the way. One of course, hold on, let's just do these one at a time. We'll do the We'll do the one that I'm quite familiar with, which is the natural gas. You'll notice that the natural gas has had a nice move now of about 10 handles up. So make sure you put your stop at, I'd put it under today's low at 182. That way you lock in $700 if you're going to do that. The NASDAQ is actually acting very poorly, folks. Last night when the market was rallying, the NASDAQ could only make a 382 retracement. Then we dropped. I mean, you talk about volatility. My gosh, it's moving 100 points at a time. That's $2,000. So this is not for the unafraid here, because these markets are jumping around, you know, with a lot of things going on. If you happen to be in the corn and the meal, those have had soybean meal, those have had some really good moves, and make sure you protect yourself on that. And I think you'll be okay. But we might start seeing some bottomings in here. But it's truly amazing, folks. If you ever have wondered, and I've been doing this a very long time, I've never seen a market like this that just climbs the wall of worry. And now we're seeing there was no reason to worry, because all those people really had jobs. They were just taking a one second, I'll talk to you about the oats. They were just taking a little break here for the holiday, so now they're back to look and see. No, the reason why I don't trade oats is there's too many other things to trade. In fact, I've really tried to get an oat chart, and I don't know how my system I go through Goldman Sachs. I don't know how how to get an oat chart. And I forgot about it. So it's just like orange juice. It's something that I don't want to be involved in. The only great oat story I can ever tell you was back in 1972. They had everything was going crazy with the Russian grain robbery. And on KFNN. What was it? KFNN? No, whatever it was, KWHY in Los Angeles. This was a show that's now CNBC. Sue Herrera, Ron Insana, Bill Griffith, a whole bunch of nice people there. And one of the guys that used to come on was Gene Morgan, and he'd have guests come in just like I do here. He had Maury Oster, who ran one of the commodity firms there in Los Angeles, there on Wilshire Boulevard. And Maury said the reason why the oats were going up was because the Arabs were buying more thoroughbred horses, and they needed the oats to feed the horses. And I tell you, that caught more press than anything we had. I mean, it was absolutely hilarious that anybody would believe something like that. Hey, but if you believe they're going to take away the police department, you know, you can believe anything. You know, that's pretty much it. I mean, it's just crazy that what we're seeing here. I'm glad that people are out social networking all night long on their protest. We're going to find out whether this thing is real or not, which it probably is, probably isn't. You take your bet, take your choice, see what happens. I've said all along, I thought it was baloney, but again, who knows? Yes, sir, Terry D., you absolutely is correct. All right, let's move on here for a second here. If I would ask Mr. David White to tell us more about record short sales, I don't follow that kind of stuff. And I would like to know, David, if you have a chance to post in there, because you be one of the smartest dudes we know, what that means. I vaguely remember it from 30 or 40 years ago, but who knows? I really don't know. We'll see what happens. All I know is that this thing, we've opened up today, is they're opening almost all of Tucson today, and they're taking off all the curfews, so it's going to be pretty much business as usual. At least that's what they're telling us so far. But the good news is, we've got breaking interest rates. You know, your portfolios are going up. All that stuff is good. Most of the people that have lost money in their 401ks have got it all back now. So that's really good. And pretty soon we'll have another 3 or 4 months of free money from the government, and then we'll be looking at it. So the fact that these bonds are going, you're telling us that the world is saying, you know, well, if you're going to give free money away, maybe these bonds are a little bit overvalued, and that's what we're seeing on the downside. They are incredibly oversold here in the bonds, but to try to pick a bottom in the bonds is like trying to pick a top in the S&P or the Dow or the NASDAQ. So those are the main things that we're watching today. So we'll keep that in mind. Remember, this is the time of the solar eclipse. So let's try it again, Larry. It's the sign of the lunar eclipse and the full moon, and it'll be followed by the solar eclipse and new moon on the 21st of June, which is Father's Day. Oh, I dread Father's Day. Oh, my gosh. You wouldn't believe it, folks. I start getting calls about 5 o'clock in the morning. There must be 25 or 30 of them from kids all across the country saying, hi, Dad, and I have no idea who they are. They're all asking for money, and I just act like I've hit the IQ scale of about 3 and disregard any of them. So anyway, we'll see what's happening. Anyway, okay, David is telling us, nope, shorts are given now probably. Okay. Yeah. I don't, hey, folks, as long as, don't be afraid of high prices. They're there for a reason. Don't be afraid of low prices. They're there for a reason also. But we'll do one of these at a time. Oh, we've got a break coming up already. Holy moly, guacamole. All right. We'll be right back, folks. 877-927-6648.
Larry Pesavento watches the markets 24/7, and now is a great time to try out his daily trading service, Fibonacci 24/7. Larry publishes videos and charts for subscribers throughout the week when warranted, and every weekend he puts out a thorough report covering worldwide markets, futures, commodities, and currencies with Fibonacci retracement levels, possible trading setups and zones, and stops and targets for all recommendations included. Larry applies the principles he's developed over decades of trading while analyzing a variety of markets for subscribers. To see for yourself the types of videos, charts, and analysis that Larry provides for his subscribers, sign up for Fibonacci 24/7 today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. You'll also gain instant access to Larry's archived subscriber webinar from earlier this year. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
All Okay, we're back, folks, and hopefully we're going to have Tim Bost do here this morning a little bit. If we can get him on the line, that'll be great. He's supposed to be calling in shortly to talk to us about the lunar eclipse and full moon that we're looking at. The fact that we're not having much volatility in the markets today probably won't mean very much, but I think the Dow's only up at, what, 700? I'm not even sure where it is. We'll have to wait and see. The NASDAQ is up slightly, but the rest of it. The main thing, folks, is we've got this big drop here in the Treasury bonds, which means the interest rates are going to be going higher a little bit for the savers, which is good. We might even get 0.75%. Wouldn't that be great? Used to be 5% of the bond standard, but they put an end to that. So let's just stop and kick the tires here just a little bit on these numbers. Now, I know that the government would never put out numbers that were not correct. I just 100% believe that. Maybe we have Tim on the line here now. And, okay, we don't have him yet, but we'll keep trying to get him. But I am sure the government would never put out numbers that were not right. I just really believe, because I know how the government is. They don't put out bad numbers. There's no question about that. We have to pay close attention to that. Now, let's go back to the old gold market, because I believe we're getting very, very close to a very significant bottom here in the gold market. If we take this four-hour chart that we've been watching in early May, we made the big double top up there. We talked about that. You had an ABCD, a lot of things up there at that 1780 level. We came down to the 61% retracement, rallied up to the 6 retracement, and that set up a price objective of 1670 to 1660. You can see what's happened over the last few days. We've been watching that to the downside, and that comes in between 1670 and 1660. And don't know if it's going to make it or not, but those are the lows that we made way back on the 21st of April. So watch 1660. And believe me, folks, you're going to be down $130, which is three full harmonic numbers. So 1660 is going to be really important in that gold market. That's where the old cowboy is going to buy a shekel, and we'll see if it'll go up from there. But it does look like it's – and remember, it's still bullish, folks. We're just having a tremendous correction here. And believe me, remember, we went from 1700 to 1450. We dropped $300 and then went up and made new highs. So this is why we're getting some great volatility in these things. You know, there's things other to trade than the S&P and the Dow E-mini and the NASDAQ and stuff. And by the way, the open interest is dropping in these things. So it's not, this is not a bullish run that we're seeing, especially in the NASDAQ. And the third of the best. The number one is the Dow, is the S&P. Number two is the Russell, also dropping in open interest. And number three is the NASDAQ. And number four is the Dow Jones. The Dow Jones has a very slight increase in open interest, but the rest of them, you really don't have that. If you have any questions, folks, it's 877-927-6648. Now, there is one other one that I think means something. Let's just get this out of the way here. We've already talked about the FTSE, and let's take a look at the FTSE, the London market. You'll see it's not anywhere near new highs. We're just back up to the 61% retracement and 78% retracement of the high from March. So this is a big ABCD here in the FTSE. So if you want to sell something, folks, and you're interested in selling something, the FTSE would be the one to sell, because it is the least it's weaker than the other. So that's mainly the same thing. And I'm sure that let's move on here to 1 second. I don't want to get in any trouble and say something that somebody will be offended by it. Heaven forbid. We don't want to talk about that. I want to talk about the U.S. dollar index, folks, because we are also at the proverbial moment of truth here, and you'll be able to see it right here. Hold on 1 second. We had a 78% retracement come in at 96.40. We're now trading at 96.92. That equated to 113.70 in the euro, and the euro's backed off quite a bit. The one that is really interesting, folks, is the British pound. I mean, it is just smoking. We're up to 127 in the British pound. Everything in Britain is okay. Boy, this is great, because we've got wonderful friends over there, and we're certainly glad glad to see that. But we're really starting to move now. I'll show you where we are here when we look at this one on the British pound. It was very strong. Whoa, just a minute, Billy Ray. Hold on. Very strong support there at 121. And now you can see we are exceeding the 61% retracement that came in at 126. We went through that like Custer lost to the that little bighorn. But anyway, listen, this thing looks higher. We've got the ABC on this, takes you to 3,100. So don't stand in front of that British pound right now, folks. Something's going on over there. I think that maybe that their parliament is going to finally Brexit and exit. I'm not sure, but something is happening with that British pound to make it strong. And we'll do that one thing at a time. So someone's asked about the silver market. Folks, the silver market is much weaker, of course, than the gold. Platinum, we really don't trade it very much. But the silver, you know, has broken well over $1.30 an ounce from the high that it made at 18.95. And I think it'll have a bottom somewhere a little bit lower in here. But the key one to watch is the gold, folks, because it has six times the volatility and open interest as the silver. So it's easier to trade. I mean, your fills are absolutely terrific. And but 1660, we're 20 bucks away in the gold market. That's one comment from somebody. So watch 1660. There should be some strong support down there in the gold at 1660. That would be one that I would be really watching very, very closely. So let's remember that these patterns are only predictive within limits, and you don't want to get stuck with something that you don't really like. The let's get the other one. I think that we wanted, we talked about the natural gas already. I wanted to make sure that everybody understood that, you know, once we have a nice profit in that, make sure at least you put a stop at 182 in that natural gas. That way you lock in $700. You know, that's the main thing to do. I put a put two recommendations out today. One of them lasted about 30 seconds in the Dow Jones. We gave up very little on trying to pick a top in that. And then the crude oil acted really nicely. We were selling crude oil at $39.40. That's picked up about $800. So put your stop at break even on that one. And we'll move on to the next one, and we'll see, you know, what happens. Oh, by the way, I will tell you this. I'm going to be doing a show on the Money Show, folks. This is where we used to go all the time. These are now streaming events. I'm going to be on June the 13th, Saturday, for about a half an hour. I'm just going to give my long-term perspective of the stocks. You know, if you listen to this show, you don't have to listen to that one, because I'll cover everything that I do there here, probably many-fold. But I actually have the people probably don't remember it, but I was the very first person that they asked to speak. This was back in 1998, I believe, when Jim Sugarman and Tim Borkman asked me to speak at the very first one in California. 877-927-6648.
The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Will the S&P 500 continue to climb? For bold trades on U.S. large cap stocks in either direction, trade SPXL SPUU or SPXS. Directions daily, S&P 500 bull and bear leveraged ETFs. Direction leveraged ETFs. An investor should carefully consider a fund's investment objective, risks, charges, and expenses before investing. A fund's prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a fund's prospectus and summary prospectus, call 866-476-7523 or visit directioninvestments.com. A fund's prospectus and summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
The Bull Bear Trading Hour with Tom and Tommy O'Brien. Next.
Okay, we're back, folks, with Tim Boss, Financial Cycles Weekly out of Sarasota, Florida. How are you, Tim?
I'm doing well, Larry. How about yourself?
Pretty good. We have a question. Are you any relation to the gentleman who owns Tim Boss Chrysler Jeep down there?
Not that I know of.
Okay.
Him send me some money. That's a good thing.
I like that. I've changed my name to Mellon and Rockefeller several times with no luck. So
let me know when that works.
You got it, brother. Listen, can you make any sense of the 2 cents that we've got going on with all the stuff happening in the market? The Dow up about 700-800 points, I guess. The S&P up 1,050. What do you think's happening, Tim?
Well, you know, we've got all the fundamentals on top of fundamentals here. You know, we had a pretty nice surprise with the jobs report earlier this morning, and I think some of its reaction there, of course. But also, we've got very, very precarious environment from an astrological perspective as well, a big feature of which is a lunar eclipse that's happening today. So we can blame that or give that some credit along the way. What I've been doing here, in fact, I've been working on a new book that's due to be out in about 10 days from now on profitable trading with eclipses. And I have done a lot of study with eclipses over the years. And what's unusual here is that over the next 30 days or so, we've got three big eclipses coming up. The first one is today with a lunar eclipse. And then 2 weeks from now on Father's Day, actually, on the 21st of June, we will have a solar eclipse that has massive significance, and then that is followed up with another lunar eclipse on the 5th of July. These three big events kind of stacking up here, and the first one is today. Now, we want to point out here some of the basics in this situation, because we regularly, of course, every month have a new moon and a full moon, and solar eclipses always occur on new moons, and lunar eclipses always come in on the full moons. These are events that occur with some frequency. We get to about two solar eclipses every year, but they're not all visible from our part of the Earth, and that is a confusing factor there. Whenever we have a lunar eclipse like we have today, it will only occur within 2 weeks of a solar eclipse. And sometimes that's before the solar eclipse, sometimes it's after. And in this case, what we've got is one before and one after, which gives this special significance here as well. So it's a remarkable event, and eclipses, in fact, do move markets. That's why we're interested in it and why we're putting together our new book on profitable trading. trading with eclipses that'll be out here in about 10 days. So what we've done is some back testing with the S&P and have found that as far as lunar eclipses go, what we're interested in determining here is whether or not they're associated with major price reversals in the S&P. And what we've found is that 1/4 of the time we'll get a reversal to the upside if the markets are in a downtrend or are trading flat. And then 44% of the time we get a price reversal to the downside. And then 31% of the time those lunar eclipses will bring no discernible reversal at all. So it's not a slam dunk, but certainly the weighting is more toward the downside with the market whenever we do have a lunar eclipse like the one today.
Wow, that's really good information to know, because everybody is they're having wonderful parties on Wall Street today. Keep going, my friend.
Right. Well, this was just an example. Not all lunar eclipses are this dramatic, but I pulled this one out of the files to look at here today. Back on January 31st in 2018, a little over 2 years ago, we had a lunar eclipse, and you can see the price reversal with the S&P there. Actually, the top was a couple of days prior to the lunar eclipse exactly, but sometimes the moves are pretty dramatic, sometimes not so much so, but again, we are looking for that that downward bias. Just as a frame of reference here, solar eclipses, we did the back testing with them as well, and they tend to have a more positive bias in terms of trend reversals. About 40% of the time, we'll see a move up back to the upside following a solar eclipse, and then 23% of the time, a move to the downside, a reversal down, and then no price reversal. 37% of the time with solar eclipses. Now, you know, maybe you and I can get together in a couple of weeks and talk about the solar eclipse, but I think because the lunar eclipse is hitting today, it's probably what we need to focus on here, because it's a lot to chew on here as we try to understand this broader perspective here. What I've got here is a little chart, and maybe hard to see, of just the visibility of the solar eclipse. That black area on the left covers the North American continent, and that indicates an area in which this lunar eclipse today is not going to be visible. In other words, it's going to have the height of visibility in Africa, Central Europe, and Asia, as well as most of Australia there. We do get a penumbral effect with the eclipse in Western Europe, including the UK, and we've been looking at some of the potential impacts on the markets in the UK with the FTSE and so forth. But we do believe that this will indicate a short-term trading top coming in probably the beginning of next week, and a pullback into that time frame of the solar eclipse, which comes up on the 21st of June. Now, this is the horoscope chart for today's lunar eclipse, which will be occurring during the final hour of the trading day. It's 12 minutes after 3 p.m. Eastern time today will be the exact moment of the lunar eclipse. And obviously, that's daylight hours in New York and the rest of the North American continent. So that's why we won't be able to see the lunar eclipse, because we need to go part of the world where it's dark at that particular time. But as I mentioned, every lunar eclipse occurs at a full moon, and what we have thereby is an opposition, astrologically speaking, of the sun and the moon. They are on opposite sides of the Earth. What makes this situation unusual with today's lunar eclipse is that we also have the sun and the moon lining up with 90-degree angles, forming a very tense pattern with the planet Mars at the same time. So this tends to juice the potential for market action and also escalate the tendencies for confrontations in social actions and geopolitical affairs as well.
Oh, Tim, how about you write on your calendar June 22nd, the day after Father's Day, and we'll have you on that day. Can you make it?
I'll be happy to do that. Absolutely.
Okay. Any webinars coming up that you're giving that you'd like to talk about?
Yes, indeed. We do have a webinar coming up. We're doing this on a weekly basis now. For those of you who are new to Astro Trading or want some tools to apply to your own trading, this is Simple Trading Tweaks to Turbocharge Your Winning Results. It's a free webinar. You can register at bit.ly/TradeTweak, TradeTweak. That's all lowercase, all one word there. And that will take you to registration options. And again, we'll be doing that on Tuesday. And you can also watch an instant replay of our most recent presentation.
Hey, listen, buddy, thanks for joining us. You have be safe out there. And we'll have you back on the 22nd of June. Tim Boss, Financial Cycles Weekly.
Thanks, Larry.
You bet. Thank you, Tim. We'll be right back, folks. 877-927-6648.
Back in the day, I joined the Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by
bam!
As well as
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Okay, I'm just going to do a quick review here. We've got those Treasury bonds have broken down below the 61% retracement. Interest rates appear to be going higher, but my gosh, when you're talking about going from 1% to 1.1%, that's really not very much. There's a lot of resistance in the E-mini S&P at 4,400, folks. We're trading at 3,183. A lot of resistance at 4,400, so keep that in mind. Also, the main one that we're watching from a trading purposes are that gold. We're short the gold. We're looking for gold to get down to this 1672 to 1660 level. That's a nice double ABCD. It's down $130 from the high. And that would be a spot that you want to take a look at the long side of gold. If you liked it at 1760, you got to love it at 1660. So that's just a double ABCD pattern. We posted it here. We're getting ready to make new lows now in gold, it looks like. So we'll watch that one very closely. The bonds have rallied about a point, but frankly, that's not even a dead cat bounce. The crude oil, we had a high in the crude oil at 39.57. The ABCD on that was at 39.47, and the high was 39.57. It's backed off to 39.07 right now. Those of you that do ABCDs is to put your stop at break even and not to worry too much about it. We just made a new low here in gold here at 16.78. So keep an eye on that, folks. It's very interesting in that gold market to see if it's going to hold up. And what we'll do is we will try to get some things to, you know, keep a close eye on it earlier today so we can watch this. And what we'll do is tomorrow is going to be a really special show. It's called Saturday. So have a wonderful weekend, boys and girls. Live every day in an attitude of gratitude. And remember, the government would never publish numbers that are wrong. Never, never, never. Well, I saw it twice in 60 years. So on Monday and Tuesday. All right, boys and girls, we will see you on the flip side, and may God bless.